Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna show you the whole process which I used to texture this character by just using Substance Painter. So this is a complete hand painted textures. So here I'm going through baking the mesh maps right now. So first I kind of just bake the normal map and just look around if there is any overlapping issues near the lip or under the eye area. If there's any issue, I might change the distance and then bake again. So right now it looks fine and I'm just gonna bake a few of the maps. And as you can see here right now, I'm kind of changing the color of the SSS and the AO color just to get the color with the base color which I need to start texturing on top of it. And now I'm kind of building a base layer for the head. So here you can see me using the crack brush right now. So I'm just gonna completely fill up the whole head with just few different brushes, the crack, maybe dirt later on. And sorry for the speed. This was actually 8 to 10 hours long video. So I had to make it shorter. So now I've changed the brush here. So if you use different brushes, it just gives you a nice variation on your base layer. And anyways, this all brushes strokes won't be visible much when you put up your last layer on top. And you can see on the left, I kind of use a lot of references, so which doesn't have shadows or specularity in it, so you just see the colors, which will help you to figure out what kind of color zones you can paint on a base. It's better to have a lot of reference. And you can see if you Google color skin color zones, you can find these kind of references, which will show you the forehead is usually yellowish tone, the area around mouth is kind of bluish or greenish. I'm just gonna fill up those red areas mostly, just the base. And it's better when you do it on a solid layer so you can change the colors. So instead of painting on just a default layer, it's better to paint on a solid layer. Now here again I've changed the brush. Just adding variation, a lot of variation into my skin. So kind of duplicated the same layer again, and you can see I'm changing the color of the solid layer. Now I'm just breaking my color zones, so I'm just adding greener tone to the area where you have mustache and beard. painting the same color tone on the scalp. Using symmetry will help you out to speed up the process again. And also keep in mind, just don't fill up the whole layer as a patch. Make sure you break the contrast on the areas which is more exposed. As you can see here, I'm kind of breaking the contrast right now, so making the mustache lighter and the beard area a little darker. So if you keep a same tone, it doesn't look nice. So it's better to have reference handy on the side so you can see the contrasty area, and it would also help you to build up variations. I've just duplicated the layer again and then changing a little bit of color, painting the under eye bag area, and then adding some more color variation to the beard and mustache. And these are really strong colors right now. Later stage, it's just gonna get blurred out or blended in with the very top layer. And definitely when you have everything in layer, you can just play with the opacity to reduce it down. And same thing, if I find that I have to go back to my red, the base red layer, and then add in few areas, you just go back and then fill it up, the mask area, with different brushes. This way you have like a lot more control with different color zones. Again, duplicating the same layer, the solid layer, and then just adding a different color zone on the forehead. And definitely on some of the areas where you have the bones are really close to the skin, so if you paint a little bit of yellow, it just gives a nice feel. So I'm painting a different color zone for the eyebrows, going back to the different layer, the blue layer. Same thing, I figured out the forehead doesn't have much of red tone in it. So going back and just painting red tone again and mixing up with a little bit of base pink just to give variation to the red tone. And always don't stick to one brush. Just play around with different brushes. Substance Painter have really good brushes like spot spray, dirt, cotton. These kind of brushes really helps out to have variation on your texture. Since we are not really relying on any photos, so it's good to have different brushes so you can break up more colors. And it's always a good practice to zoom out your model and just see, look around, how does the textures and the color zones are looking in a far away view. So I duplicated the same layer, and then now I'm just gonna paint the darker areas on my skin. Which I could have used occlusion map, but I would like to paint and just to break as much radiation I can. This one I'm kind of applying a cavity map here. It's not actually a cavity map, it's a curvature map which is baked and then inverted. And this is I'm just using on a very low opacity, just to have a little more break in the skin. Even if you paint this like really dark, you can just always go invert the mask and paint it out those darker areas, or you can use layer opacity to dial it down. I just duplicated the layer again, and now just painting the lighter tones, the very first layer of the skin, epidermis. And you can see here in the reference, the chin is Like it has a lot more color than what I had on my character right now. So I'm just going back again, painting some of the colors back in, so it should not look completely white. And even cutting down some of the epidermis. It's always better to reduce the stroke opacity and the flow of your brush, so the intensity shouldn't be higher, so you don't lose all the base colors which you had painted earlier. So now I'm just painting all the red color again and breaking the skin tone more. I usually play with colors like bluish or adding a little bit of pink tones. It just breaks the color which you are painting. So it should not look just red or just green or just yellow. So it's better to have a little bit of different color information. Since this is a stylized head, it's not completely realistic, but I'm just giving a treatment of realistic texture to this guy. So it's always better to have some good references with you so you can read and observe how the color changes are there. Now I've created a blending layer and I'm just going to use different brushes and just going to pick color from my texture and then just start painting on top of it. Here I'm putting again some blue and red color tone back on the chin. You can add more variation by adding veins to your skin and few other color variations. Especially around the nose. So all these small brush strokes will help you to break the skin much better, so it should not look like an equal skin color tone. Because it looks really empty around the nose area and especially around the eyes right now. So I'm just gonna fill up with these small changes, which is painting those small breakups, which will bring some realism to the skin texture. And this part I am trying to build a smart material where I can just paint stubble on it. If you use different brushes or for painting the stubble, it will break up more. Instead of using just a thick brush, maybe like a basic hard brush or basic soft brush, it won't give you the variation which will look nicer instead of using those brushes. You can try out spray or dirt brushes to paint out those stubbles. Right now it's not much visible. I'm gonna duplicate the layer to make the effect more visible. Now I'm just gonna cover up the scalp. So after painting the darker dots, I'm just gonna duplicate the same layer and using this as a lighter dots to make it more believable stubbles. And blurring them out a little bit. And you can see it just really brings the stubble look a little more realistic than just painting like a black patch. As you can see in some of the texture references. You can also paint directional stubbles by just changing the brush to square and by changing the values, making it thinner on the x-axis so you can have a directional stubbles. Because usually just you don't have a single dot overall on your face. Yeah, like some of the areas will have different stubble, I mean different direction. So you can try to break these more by using these brushes. So you can see here, I'm just trying to show you how I build up the whole base. So every layer by layer, this is still not yet done. You can also play with subsurface inside Substance Painter, which is a really nice feature to see how the skin will look. So now I'm just going back to painting the skin, the shadows or darker tones. and just go back and forth, check your model in material view as well, not just in color. You can try iRay, which is a really nice feature. So you can see here how your skin is gonna look at the end. So now I'm just painting roughly some of the breakups on the skin. So this is the final stage which I'm done. So this is the final texture for this character. I hope you like the process which I went through. So I hope you liked the video. Thank you.